All right, you've got a friend or a family member who's a woodworker. The holidays are coming, or maybe it's a birthday. You want to get them some kind of gift, but you have no idea what to get them because they live a strange life and they have strange needs and desires, and you don't really understand any of it. So I'm going to give you some ideas today on what you can get them for a gift. It might be easier than you think. Purchasing big tools for a woodworker can be tough because you don't know what they have or what they want. And it's a very personal decision. So rather than spend all that money, I'm going to concentrate on smaller items that make a woodworker happy and you might not have thought of. Here's my first example. Woodworkers have to finish their work sooner or later. Whether they're painting it or staining it or whatever, part of the process is just figuring out what the color is that they need, or even sometimes which finish to use. So one thing you can do is to buy a small selection of stains, for example, or this is milk paint, or even just paint itself, so that they have, you know, small samples to work from after they finish whatever they're working on. They can test different samples on it. And that's a great thing to have around in a shop on a shelf. And it's fairly inexpensive gift. Also, a paint swatch book is really nice to have. These are about 15 bucks at a lot of paint stores. They'll sell them to you. Sometimes they'll give them to you for free even. But having a whole selection of colors to choose from can make finishing a project a lot easier. While we're on the subject, paintbrushes, just cheap ones, these are shop brushes they call them, which are used for testing finishes or spreading glue sometimes. And there are other ones that are called chip brushes, same idea. Just cheap brushes to have on hand so you're doing little projects, you can test something real quick and then just throw it out. Or even just getting nicer paintbrushes too is a good idea. These are always good to have on hand. Your woodworker probably does his or her work in a garage or a basement or something, and you need to sweep up after the day is done, so you may be able to upgrade them to a nicer broom. A dustpan like this one is really nice. It's made of aluminum, so it doesn't rust, but because it is metal, it holds up for heavy-duty use. And even a hand brush like this one, they wear out constantly, so you can't go too far wrong buying one of those. So possibly you can upgrade them to a nicer set of tools like this. Having a selection of nails or screws on hand is really handy when you're doing a project. And what you might want to consider doing is getting a whole set of boxes of a particular set of nails or screws for your woodworker. For example, you could go into a Home Depot or Lowe's or something and pick up deck screws, which are often used in construction, as are drywall screws, and just get one box of every size. That way they have a whole selection on hand. If you have access to an antique store or some kind of flea market, you might be able to pick up boxes of old screws, which, depending on what kind of woodworking they're doing, may be very handy. And again, if you can get a selection of a whole different bunch of sizes, that's great. And if you have a woodworker who does work on, you know, period appropriate furniture, that kind of thing, you may be able to get boxes of nails, a whole selection that are made by the Tremont Nail Company, which are old-fashioned style nails, and those are great to have on hand. Basic supplies can be really nice to have on hand too. You have dust respirators if they're doing a lot of work, especially in a small area where they may not have dust collection system. And that helps protect them, so that's always good to have on hand. Things like gloves are always good to have when you're moving lots of lumber. Disposable gloves for when you're doing finishing. And just having a box or two of these on hand is just great. And another thing you might not think of is ball jars for when you're mixing stains or finishes. These are really nice to have. And because it has a top, it allows you to keep the stain or mix of finish a little bit longer than you might otherwise. So getting a box of ball jars is a wonderful idea too. Another idea for supplies is just getting more finishing supplies like 3M pads, different types of sandpaper, so you can get, you know, just boxes of different grits of sandpaper. Steel wool is another thing. Just having these things on hand makes a big difference when you're reaching for something to finish a project and it's there versus having to go to the store to go get it. A lot of woodworkers who live in colder climates end up freezing just because they're working out in the garage or something. And one idea would be to get a heater of some sort. You don't want to spend too much, and keep in mind this is a utility heater. So you could get a blower type like this or a propane powered heater like this. But providing some extra heat in the garage or a basement would really be great and well appreciated by most woodworkers. I did in a previous video a review of this vacuum cleaner, and that's another great idea, is just to get a small vacuum cleaner that they can use for dust collection and cleaning up after themselves after they've done a project. And if they have an older one that needs renewing, or they don't have one at all, this is a great idea. A lot of woodworkers appreciate older tools, so if you are near an auction or a flea market, you may be able to get maybe some old hand planes, and they may use them or they may just display them, but they're a fun gift to have and they're not very expensive. Clamps are a wonderful idea. These are pipe clamps, and there are all sorts of other clamps available. Woodworkers never have enough clamps, so no matter how many you may see in your woodworker friend's shop, there are always room for more and more styles. So go to your local big box store and pick up some clamps and they will be very happy. Sawhorses are obviously a useful item for any woodworker, and sometimes there's personal preference in this, but if you pick up a pair of folding sawhorses, it's something they could use for extra pair when they need them and put them away somewhere safe when they're not needed. So that's a good idea. Woodworkers go through some hand tools pretty quickly, like tape measures and utility knives. So even if your woodworker has some of these, more are always appreciated. I know I keep a pile on hand so that when one breaks, I have another one I can just pick out of a drawer. Tarps are always needed by woodworkers, especially if you're making built-ins and houses and that kind of thing. So a selection of new tarps for painting or for protecting floors or whatever are always appreciated. And this stuff right here is another interesting thing you might not think of. This is basically, it's a very thick saran wrap is what it comes down to. This particular brand is sold at Lowe's, and it's in the department where they sell rugs and that sort of thing. But basically, it unwraps like saran wrap, and you can put it on top of, you know, furniture, on top of flooring, or whatever to protect it while you're working around it. So that's a great idea. Extension cords are another item where you almost can't have too many of them. And if you get some different sizes, maybe a 25 foot, maybe a longer one like 100 foot, and make sure you get a heavy duty size, one designed for power tools and that kind of thing, that will certainly be appreciated. Finally, when your woodworker's not actually in the shop, he or she will like reading about their craft. So here's some ideas that you might think about. Magazine subscriptions are a great idea. Two very well respected magazines are Fine Home Building and Fine Woodworking. And depending on what kind of woodworking they do, either one of those might be appropriate. And there's lots of books for woodworking. Here's a few I just happened to pick off my shelf, but there's dozens more. And that's another good idea. You have to match the book to the level of woodworking that your friend or your family member does, but that's another great idea because it's nice to curl up on a couch and just read about the craft sometimes rather than actually being out in the shop and doing it. So those are some of the ideas I have for you, and I hope they help you out.